Shambho, Mahā. Namaskaram. Namaskaram to everyone. Well, of the two fundamental dimensions of our existence, time and energy. Let's talk about time, because that is what many of you are struggling with. Lockdown. Oh, 2 more weeks. Well, as in many, many ways, we have said this, time is very little for a human being. Only one who does not explore the nature of what it means to be human, only for that person it's too much time. But if you explore the dimension of being human, then the time allotted is very cruelly short. This most people realize only when the moment of death comes. It once happened. When Kaveri used to be in full flow, one day Shankaran Pillai fell into the river and started drowning. So he screamed for help, but the river was full. Nobody willing to risk their life. They all looking, if it was easier they would have got him, but this looked like a tough one. His wife was screaming. Then he went down, and when he came up, he shouted, "Whoever saves my life will give 1 crore." Then 2 young boys looked at each other and said, "Why not?" And they jumped in. They went and dragged him out. And they said, "All right, now you're alive, 1 crore. He said, "50 lakhs. They said, "You said 1 crore, but I was only half drowned. I was not fully drowned. I was only half, I was still coming up." So if you pick the dead body, you could get 1 crore. Because anyway, whatever number of damn crores you have, you will leave it behind and go. You must always never miss a funeral. Anybody that you know, somebody who dies, your friends, relatives, you must always go in India. It's a compulsory, even if you don't go for weddings, this function, that function, it's okay. When death happens, you have to be there. It's a very good thing. You will see, yesterday this man was full on, suddenly he's like this. You show him gold, diamond, whatever his favorite food, his wife cries, his children cry. It's a yogi, huh? Only problem is dead. He should have done this little earlier. Little early, if he could be like this, that nothing sways him, then he becomes a human being. To be a human being means just that, you know how to be. Something else does not determine how you are. Something else, material or otherwise, does not determine how you are. You are a being, that means you know how to be. What kind of games we play? We play. Everybody has to play something. You play what you like. I will not prescribe what kind of game you must play. But once nothing really sways you, you will play a kind of game that's useful, in some way good for life around you, because anyway it doesn't matter to you. So the time does not know when you will be born. Time is just a ruthless wheel which is just rolling. It does not know when you will be born, it does not know when you will die, because I'm saying this because those astrologers and others who are losing a little bit of business because of me are going at me these days because time does not know when you will be born, when you will die. People think it's written in the time, no. Time is a ruthless wheel, keeps rolling. It is you, out of your karmic substance, your intelligence and present karma, if you ride it, if you ride the wheel, you have a great experience of life. If you fall down, the time won't stop, it'll roll over you. It's just like any wheel, I'm saying. You're… you know, this happens unfortunately many times. This I witnessed with my eyes, you know, I went and saw this. In Mysore city, if I mention the name of the area, many people may remember this incident. In Chamundipuram, the bus terminus is such, it comes there and it has to back up and then go back. So those days, conductors always, this is part of the Indian bus conductor, he'll have a pencil behind his ears. A small piece of pencil, he will pull it out and he has to enter to prevent pilferage and corruption in the bus. Every time he gives out this many tickets, from bus stop, he has to enter in a small sheet. Anytime the inspectors can come and check what has he entered, how much cash is there, that kind of stuff. So always he has a pencil behind his ears. So every day he does this job, I don't know how many years, because when I looked at him, he must have been around 40 years of age. So at least 15 years he might have served as a bus conductor. So the bus is backing up. Usually the conductors and drivers have a kind of rapport, they work together, it's a team. So the driver is backing up. The conductor says simply, right, 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 so that he doesn't go and hit somebody. So his pencil falls down and rolls. Because he's used to this every day, he goes and tries to pick up the pencil and the bus rolls over him. It went right over his shoulder. Within 3 to 5 minutes after this incident happened, I was there and I saw this man was crushed by the bus that he always rides. This is his job, every day he rides this bus. But if you fall down, the wheel doesn't stop, that's the problem. The driver could have stopped, that's different with a bus wheel. But he didn't realize this guy is saying right, right, he didn't say stop, he just went crunch. So this is the nature of time, it's rolling. If you ride it, it's fantastic. If you fall under it, it will crush you and keep going. So the time itself does not know a thing, it is a ruthless force. But it is that ruthless force which is a major ingredient of our lives. At least 50% for sure. If you take charge of your energies, then you can push the participation or the role of time, you can minimize, you can make it 40%, you can make it 30%, you can make it 20%. Otherwise, it will increase its participation or its role. If you're not doing much, if you're not taking charge of yourself, well, it could become 90%. Such people are always looking at what is good time, what is bad time, where are the stars rolling, what is happening? Because you have allowed time to become a major part of your life, you have not taken charge of your energies. So this is a time where you have time on your hands. It's better you learn to ride it. If you learn to ride it, you will see someone who is riding, you know, the wave riders, someone who is riding a wave, no wave is big enough and long enough, the damn thing gets over too quickly. Similarly, if you're riding time, you will see 100 years, 200 years if you live, it gets over too quickly. But if you're being crushed every second, ah, you want to do experiment? No? We'll crush you with something, just see how long each second becomes. When you're being tortured, then every second is too long. When you're then the whole life is too short. Oh, Sadhguru, everything is good for you, so you're talking like this, do you know my husband, my wife, my mother-in-law, my boss? I think generally all of them are not with you right now. Maybe you're stuck with them. It's not about them, I want you to understand. People are there, variety of people. I'm not innocent of such people, I've seen plenty of them, always, okay? Not new to me. People who behave nasty, do nasty things, they're not new to me and they've not spared me. After so many years, maybe there is some distance, otherwise every kind of nasty human being you can meet, I've met on the way. It's just that I didn't allow their nastiness to rub off on me, that's all. I try to rub off my blissfulness on them, some of them got it, some of them didn't get it, but I didn't allow them to rub off their nastiness upon me, that's all. And that's all the choice you have too. There are pleasant situations, there are unpleasant situations, there are horrific situations sometimes, it happens. So will you determine to whatever extent you can the nature of situations that you get into, or will you allow the situations to determine the nature of who you are? This is the question behind every human being, otherwise we will take off the being, we will call you human creature. That's an appropriate title for you. If something else decides how you are, obviously you're a creature. You're not a being. So these 15 days, government is very generous. See, this extension of lockdown everywhere in the world, but we're in India, for example, because we are here. In India, it's coming at a great economic and political cost. It's not a popular thing to do, but it's a very wise thing to do. Will 15 days be enough? We don't know. If everybody, every citizen in this country absolutely locks down for 15 days, it's definitely enough. But there are free radicals. Because of them, we don't know if it will be enough or not. But after some time, whether it's enough or not enough, anyway they will open up. Maybe in stages, but they will open up, not because we have mastered the virus, simply because we have not yet become human beings. Human creatures are getting restless. They will work against their own well-being. But 15 days, believe me, is a lot of time. If you know how to make use of it, 15 days is a phenomenal amount of time. What can I do in 2 weeks? A lot. You can look at it as 15 days, you can look at it as 2 weeks, or you can look at it as 1 fortnight, or it's just half a month. Half a cycle of the moon. In half a cycle, what can I do? You can do a lot. You can do a lot with yourself. Maybe you cannot do much in the world in 15 days, but you can do a phenomenal amount of work upon this person if this one is a willing participant. The world is always unwilling. I know this better than anybody, believe me. even if you're offering them the best, still their willingness comes in installments over many years. Slowly yielding. But if you are doing something with this one, with yourself, it's a willing participant, it must be. That also, if it's unwilling and it comes in stages, of course you need 15 lifetimes. Otherwise, 15 days is a phenomenal amount of time for anybody. So these 15 days, there are many ways. If you want, we can throw out 3 different levels of sadhana you can do. Very intense, you're alone in your home, you have no obligations, you can go one way. You have medium level of obligations, you can go another way. You have a lot of stuff, you can go another way. Like this, 3 different levels of sadhana, we can put it out tomorrow online if you want. But only if you're going to do it. Otherwise, why am I saying this is, the tools, the subjective tools, it's very important. Every fool who is not practicing or who is not serious about it should not get it, because once in a way they will poke themselves, that's not good. When a tool is given in this country, if you know, if people have to take a book or a pen or even you will see the labor who comes here, if they want to pick up a pickaxe or a crowbar, they'll pick it up like this, because the tool is very important in a human, in human life. It's only because of tools we are who we are. We have a dominant place on this planet, not because we are so strong, we are so fantastic, no. We have the ability to use tools, which makes us immensely powerful and capable. What you call as technology is just a complex version of tools. So, those who are not using the tools properly, but once in a way they go and poke themselves with the tool, not good. Because any number of careless workers who are using something as simple as a pickaxe, many times, you know, you don't know how to nail something in your wall. I've seen this repeatedly with people. You ask them to nail something, tuk, 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 4th one is on the thumb. Because you have not learnt how to use a tool, once in a way you pick it up. Subjective tools, unless you have a certain commitment, throwing it out is not good. But if you're not committed for 15 days to do this, you should not look at that part of the message that we send out. You must just ignore it. If you're willing to use it, we will put it out there. Something very simple, extremely simple things, which can do tremendous things for human life. Just small things, how you sit, how you breathe, what you do, a few things, this will transform itself. Because in terms of evolution, you're already a human being. But you're refusing to be one, that's all. You're just refusing to be one, old habit. This is like millions of years of habit of being instinctive, reactive, compulsive. Now suddenly you don't have to be, but still you are. It's like a bird lived in a cage for a long time, then one day you remove the door, but he doesn't fly out. His wings are intact, he is capable of flying, still there is atmosphere on the planet, but he won't fly. Because habit food comes into the cage, why fly and look for it? So out of habit, you must understand habit means you are becoming a compulsive creature. This is why it's important, everything that you do, you consciously do it. Even if some things are set every day for your life, still you approach that also as a conscious process. You don't do it as a habit. Habit means you are just becoming automated. Automation may bring some efficiency into certain things, but we don't need you for that. We don't need you for automation. Machines will do better automation than you. You're supposed to be here, the value of you is that you're alive and you know how to be. These 15 days must be made use of that, for that. And I think we have something to show you. I've been little busy with something. Can you put on the video?
Bhairava, the most handsome bull you could imagine. He's been with us for many years. So I thought, in honor of him, I will do a piece, an artwork. So I'm using cow dung as a basis, as a background. As a background for the painting, just plain cow dung with, mixed with water. And I plan to do this entirely with organic material like charcoal, maybe some turmeric and lime, limestone. That's what I'm thinking right now. But what exactly I'm going to do, the picture is not clear in my head yet. But this is in honor of Bhairava, the wonderful and gentle beast that he was. Everybody loved him. Well, this is cow dung. Long time since I handled it. When I lived in the farm, it was quite normal to, you know, do the floor and other things with this. But it's been a long time because people have been, well, being on the social media, battling a lot of bullshit. But cow dung is a different matter. Not a gender prejudice, but just a terminology. How the sacred soil becomes dirt for somebody else. Similarly, in a pastoral culture, cow dung was used in multiple ways to disinfect the homes, as manure, as fuel, medicinal values to it, because in a pastoral culture, a bovine animal was everything, every aspect of it, not just the edible aspects of milk and butter and ghee and those things, but every aspect of the cow was made use of, because cow and cattle were so much absolute part of this culture and its wealth at one time. Wealth was not measured in terms of land, because there was plenty of land. It is how many cattle you have, that was your wealth. So, nice to be handling sacred cow dung, because we even make vibhuti out of it, which is used as an application. It's a good change to be handling the sacred cow dung instead of the social media bullshit on a daily basis. But I hope I'll come up with something wonderful in honor of Bhairava. I hope I can do some justice to the beautiful beast that he was. I'm not using the word beast in a negative way. The beautiful bovine that he was may be more fair to him. Spectacular creature he was. This is just plain cow dung, soaked in water and filtered off all the solid particles that may be there in it. And it's taking a little bit of time.
So, oh, still on. So, took a few days to come up with this. The first time I'm working with a medium like this, what's a white patch, huh? Oh, okay. What are the white pets? No, is it visible? So because all this was getting bit of a little bit of a serious theme, we did something more fun. See, I must be missing something, huh? Thank you, please.
This question is from Ridhima. Namaskaram, Sadhguru. Thanks for being there every day for the last 40 days. I am a little scared that now we won't be having this darshan. How can I access you? You had mentioned that you are available beyond space, but I am just not sure what to do to experience your presence all the time.
So what is presence and what is a person are two different things. Presence is a universal thing. It's not mine or yours. There is a phenomenal presence always. It's like there is air. Because there is air, a flower blossoms, Maybe most people who are not from this part of the world wouldn't have seen this flower. This is one of the most fragrant flowers. So the flower blossoms, throws its fragrance into the air, and in a way, it becomes the flower's presence. You're walking by, you feel the flower's presence. By itself, it cannot do this. Because there is air, it rides it. So presence doesn't belong to me or you. Question is only, can you become available to it? Can you ride it a little bit? Well, even filth has its own presence. A flower has its own presence. So we're just letting our qualities ride on the fundamental presence. Those who become concrete blocks, not just physically, in every way, they think this is it. They need a virus. Really. When either your physical body becomes either very strong or maybe very beautiful, or your mind becomes very strong and it thinks it's very smart and intelligent, then it becomes an entity of its own, like this. It doesn't feel the presence upon which our life is riding. It is thinking all by itself. Suddenly the fear of virus, little, beginning to understand this is not so much of a solid block. If somebody sneezes, you may die. Yes. If you want to scare people around you, I know somebody will just cut this and say, Sadhguru's got coronavirus. If you once the lockdown is over, you're standing in a queue, everything is a queue and long queues because 6 feet space everywhere, your bank, your grocery store, wherever you go, long queue. If you want to find your way quickly, all you have to do is cough. People behind you will be still there, but people in front of you will move away. You can go. Only thing is, by the time you go to the top of the queue, they may pick you up and take you away. Today people are experiencing the ambulance like a police van. Because you were taken away. 14 days quarantine, imprisonment, whatever you want to call it. At 14 days you're in somebody's control because you do not know how to manage yourself. So, presence is always there. A certain quality to the presence is what we are trying to create, so that something that you know, you can recognize. Something that you do not know, once in a way you may feel it. At certain moments in one's life, somebody may feel just the sheer presence of existence. It is so phenomenal and its magnitude is like a zillion, zillion, zillion times more than who we are. So, how one doesn't feel it is a miracle. But once in a way, somebody may touch that. But there may not be, it may be asymptomatic. Because of that, you don't feel the air, though you're always breathing it. But a flower, you're feeling the fragrance. But actually you're just feeling the air with a little tinge of something. So in that sense, this is what a personal presence means, that you create a little tinge to it. You're also riding on that. Presence is not yours, it is cosmic, it is universal. You're also riding on it. But because others cannot feel it normally, because it's everywhere, if it was in one place and not in another place, they would have all found it. Because it's everywhere, people don't feel it, so you create a quality to it. Well, it's available through the day, but we have created certain times of the day. Don't ask me why, there's a whole history to it, someday I will tell you. It's a long story. Why it is 6:20? Morning, evening. Only certain kind of people are doing morning presence because they are on a specific kind of sadhana. Others are all doing evening 6:20. In case you are a 4:20, please go 2 hours ahead. No, only Indians understand what is 4:20. It's not just time. So, all you have to do is 2 hours skip you must do to 6:20. At this time, we made it, set it up in such a way, it is strong. You see, in the evening, flowers are there throughout the day, but in the evening, their fragrance is little strong for that one and a half hours. Just like that, for about 40 minutes it's strong, 20 minutes is very strong, up to 40 minutes is pretty strong. So, there is, I think, in the downloadable app, there is a presence, how to do it. Just go through that. Well, darshan is not over, 43 days you had to stare at your screen. Now you can close your eyes and enjoy the presence. It'll be more wonderful, I'm telling you. Instead of all this gossip, you can just close your eyes and enjoy the presence. I will be there for you, definitely.
Next question is from Deepika. Sadhguru, you said in one of the darshans that you should treat everyone just as you would treat me. Sadhguru, you are a Karuna avatar. But I have one inhuman nasty creature in my home. It becomes difficult to see you in him. how to deal with him in this situation?
How many years of marriage does this evolution happen? Or it's a devolution? I'm sure he was a wonderful, romantic, wonderful man at one time. I don't know in how many years of marriage does he become a nasty creature. And how much role you have in making of a nasty creature. See, especially if he is nasty creature, especially if it is so, this is your perception. But especially if somebody is a nasty creature in your home or in your office or wherever you seeing something in a certain way is not about them, it's about you. Do you want to keep your eyes, your mind, your heart, your body pleasant or unpleasant? You make up your mind on that one. Now, if you look at him, I said even that nasty creature, please look at him, it's like me. I'm not telling you that you have to listen to his teaching or take new practices from him. No. I'm saying, if you have looked at me with a certain sense of reverence, devotion, love, affection, whatever is your emotion, if you have, please see everything with that, because all I'm saying is, you have a body, you have a mind, you have emotion, energy. We're talking about your emotion right now. If you hit a certain level of sweetness of emotion, at one point in your life, either because of your love or devotion or compassion or whatever, you hit a certain level of sweetness, this is the high point in your life. Now, you should not come back from that, you must see how to go beyond that. I'm saying whatever was the highest or the sweetest or the most wonderful emotion you had, make that the baseline, why are you coming back again? If you did not know such an emotion, then what would I tell you? Which is the sweetest emotion you had in your life? My child, okay, see everybody as your child. You've told you that at one time. Then I saw you sat here with tears of blissfulness and love coming out of you. Then I said, see everybody as you're looking at me right now. Because this will make your eyes, your mind, your heart, your body and your very being sweet and wonderful. This is not about him. Especially if he is being difficult, then you are being well trained. Even if you go to hell, you will do well. Yes. Because nobody has guaranteed you. Have I ever told you I will get your ticket to heaven? I've been constantly threatening you, right here things will happen. So, you must understand this is about your transformation. The problem with you is, because you read… what are those? You are not first of all straight with yourself. Your hormones are working up. Suddenly you look at somebody, wow! Can't believe she's so beautiful, she's so fantastic, he's so handsome, he's so wonderful, everything he does, ah! You're bullshitting yourself. No, no, whatever they do, you make yourself beautiful. Now even if they're doing nasty things, you're still wonderful. This is different, you know they're doing nasty things. And you're still wonderful, this is fantastic. They are doing nasty things, but you think they are doing beautiful things. This is a stupid nonsense. I'll tell you, somebody who was serving in Indian Army had told me this story because we went through a similar situation somewhere else. So at that time he was narrating this. They were posted in the northeastern region where there's a certain amount of elephant population. So he's a battalion leader, he's heading about a group of 18 to 20 people, I think, they're marching in the forest. And they see a huge tusker, everybody backs off, all of them have weapons, okay, powerful weapons. This is an anti-insurgency group, that means they're fully armed and equipped. They can shoot down a tusker from 100 meters, 200 meters, whatever they want. But they all back off because that's not the reason why they are there. But he was telling me this because this some situation happened like this with one South Indian person. So suddenly there was one Tamil man in the thing who was a sergeant, Hawaldar. He put his weapons down and he said, "Ganapati has come, Ganesha, Ganesha." And he started chanting a mantra. He knew some Ganapati mantra, he started chanting, he ran in front and he went close to the elephant just 50 feet away and went down on his knees and started loudly saying the chant. The elephant looked at him, "Who is this bloody fool, you know? Calling him all kinds of names that he doesn't like." And these people were watching, this is some kind of a miracle happening, the elephant is just standing there and this guy is on his knees chanting. The elephant moved so quickly, and within less than 2 seconds or within probably 5 seconds, he was upon him, he just crushed him, turned back and went. These people were just aghast and they just watching him being crushed. Then some people pulled out the weapons when the person whom I knew was in charge of it, he calmed them down because it's already dead. The man is dead in one shot. Why I'm saying this to you is, elephant will not do, wild elephant is not going to do pleasant things to you because you call him a god. You call him Ganapati and try to worship him, he is not going to do, he will do what he has to do. Similarly, the creature in your house, he will do what he has to do, whatever is his characteristic. It is just about you I am talking. You're always thinking of life as a relationship. No, no. I want you to understand, before you were born or even when you were being born, you did not have a relationship even with your mother. This is going to be very unpopular, people are going to pick on me, but please look at it, you don't have a relationship. You just have an existence. Relationship happened because of your needs. You saw her as your food, you went for her, you saw her as the basis of your survival. You recognize that quickly, you know. The moment a child is born, hand her over to another man or another woman and let them take care of all the child's needs. Child will immediately go to them. This whole idea that you think it's coming to you because you are the mother and you delivered, no. It is because of the needs you form relationships. Otherwise, there is just existence. This existence can either become conscious and live in a phenomenal presence, become available to it, or just do or go on doing the circus. Initially, your mother was everything, she was the most fantastic creature, and then you grew up, you became an adolescent, you saw a boy, he was the most fantastic man in the world. Then your mother came in between, suddenly you started hating her. Hello? Then the man came, he was most beautiful, then he became a nasty creature, or so you thought. Now you think he is the worst human being. This goes on. I want you to understand, you're making up both beauty and nasty. I am not asking you to make up. I am not asking you to think whatever this person is doing is fantastic, that's a stupid way to exist. It's just that if you see everything, whatever is the peak experience you've had, make that the baseline, this is growth. You played the snake and the ladder game, swing, swing, shk. You played that game, snake and the ladder game. So when you play this game, your intent is once you climb a ladder, you don't want to come back. You don't want to hit a snake, you want to find another ladder, go up, that's a natural expression of life. So once you know a certain level of sweetness within you, don't bring it down, that should be the basis. The next thing should be better and better. So when I said every… right now you are sitting here with tears of ecstasy and love like this with me, then I said, let this be the basis, don't go down from this. See everything as this, at least let this much happen. If this is continuously happening, constantly happening, then of course you will hit another ladder, just a little bit of time. Don't come down, that's all I said. And please don't describe him as a nasty creature, poor man. This happened. I think I told you, maybe one of these days only I told you, I don't remember, but let me repeat this. Shankaran Pillai thought his wife is having an affair, hired a detective, I'm saying it loudly because just to remind you, said, I want proof against her. So detective just waited outside the house, she left the house, he followed her, then she went to parked near the park, went inside, a man was sitting on the bench, the moment he saw her, he came running, she went running, they hugged, each other held hands and sat down on the bench and chatting away joyfully, laughing. He took the whole video and within a few hours he came to Shankaran Pillai in his office and said, I got all the proof that you wanted just in one day. I did my job, I have the proof, here, watch the video. Shankaran Pillai started watching the video and said, no, I can't believe this, no, no, this can't be, I can't believe this, no, I can't believe this. I said, what you can't believe? It's a video, it's not doctored, it's just a video that I took just now. He said, that's not the point, fool, I can't believe she's so much fun. So, after 15 days is over, when the man goes away somewhere, then you will see how much fun he was. Don't do this to yourself. I think we've… It's 7 o'clock, all of you are still there or closed your screens, I don't know. Anyway, one more question, we'll finish.
This question is from Chaitanya. Sadhguru, the cases in India are increasing and with the lockdown opening, it might pick up the pace. I would like to know if I get corona, how do I deal with it emotionally?
Oh, the virus does not understand your emotions. So, don't deal with it emotionally. First thing, don't get it, but it may happen. Once you're out on the street, it may happen. So please don't deal with it emotionally. No, 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 that's not what I'm saying. So how should I handle my emotion? This is what I was saying all this time. Your emotion, whatever is the sweetest point you hit in your life, the high point, you must keep it there, don't bring it down. So, if virus gets you, you must deal with it sensibly. The most sensible thing is, if you get it, nobody else should get it from you. This commitment you must take for yourself, for the sake of the nation and for the sake of humanity. You must take this, in case you get it, it should not hop to one more person. You must stop here. Either we come out of it alive or we die or we come out whichever way, but it should not go to one more person. This responsibility we must take. So there is no emotional stuff to it. You deal with it, it'll be a little hard to breathe. People say it's quite terrible because it feels like you're drowning. But then now it is showing other symptoms also, various other kinds. So, we don't know what kind of sweet emotions virus has for you or not. We do not know. We do not know if he has any emotions, he's just doing his business. Simply, he's just going about his business of survival. So you go about your business of survival, that's it. Just like the virus, all right? The virus is trying to survive upon you. You survive upon this planet, don't go away. No emotion needed for this. Just what is needed, you hand yourself over to a doctor, whatever they have to do, they will do, you take instructions and just do that. Or before the lockdown is over, fully inform yourself what you must do, what you must not do, absolutely, 100% clear. But if you keep yourself, we have taught you Sima Kriya, but if you're already doing Shakti Chalana Kriya, your immune system is good in terms of food. Have you put out everything? Various things? Maybe we can put it out with little more, you know, little rejig that a little bit. How to get the immune system up? Use these 15 days to really get the immune system into a strong place. In spite of that, we can get it. But now they're saying 80% of the people who get it don't show any symptoms. They just go through it, nothing happens, it's just that they're giving it to other people, that's all. So if you're in the vulnerable age group, you must be super careful, for your lockdown is not over. If you're over 60, 65 years of age, if you have any kind of immune deficiency disorders, for you, lockdown is not going to get over on 17th of May. It's not going to get over for next 6 months, 8 months, 9 months, we don't know, maybe 12 months. Those who are young and healthy, yes, you have to get back to activity and do things. Others have to maintain, those who are in the vulnerable groups, they have to maintain lockdown. And everybody, you need to understand, even if the lockdown gets over, you must understand this is not because we got on top of the virus. Simply because we can't afford to stay home, both in terms of economy, in terms of various other social things, we cannot continue to stay back, so we're going out. Virus is not saying, yes, I'm done, I'm defeated. There's no such thing. Nothing has been done about the virus. Forget about a vaccination, we still don't have a treatment protocol which is clear and everybody says this is the way to do it. We've not arrived at that. Simply we're trying many things that we normally do when we get something else and managing. Those who are strong are coming out of it, those who are not are going down. So these numbers may definitely increase, there is no need to panic. What is needed is sense. Keep sufficient distance, it doesn't matter, your friend or foe, if your friend, you don't have to hug them. Enemy, don't have to slap them. A slap could be very dangerous. So, don't do anything, all right? Do minimal contact with people, with distancing. This must be maintained for next few months. Doesn't matter, government says you can go out, they are saying that out of the compulsions of national economy and various other things that need to happen. You can't keep people locked down forever. But it's phenomenal that more than 6 weeks we have successfully locked down, largely very successful, fantastic. Today, the Indian forces, all the tri-forces of Army, Navy and Air Force have been around the country honoring all the COVID warriors, as they're called today, the doctors, the medical professionals, the police and others, who have played a significant role in managing it this way. Right now, the acknowledgement in the world is the best managed, the one who has managed this whole virus thing best is Taiwan, but that's a much smaller country. The next second best is India, as to how we have managed. With the kind of diversity of people that we have, diversity of languages, because let's say in United States, if the president or somebody speaks in English language, everybody understands. This is not like that, you have to speak in 28 languages. All right, and there are many people who don't understand any language. In spite of the complexity of the social structure, which no other nation has this kind of complex structure in terms of language, race, religion, everything. In spite of that, it has been, you know, managed in a fantastic way with minimal amount of force, and people have cooperated in a significant way. We really have to congratulate the Indian people. They're now getting little restless because they thought tomorrow they're going to step out after midnight today. So now there will be a certain amount of frustration for the next 2-3 days, but I'm sure they will cooperate and take this on. This 15 days, if all of us absolutely follow lockdown, not because it's government instruction, all of us absolutely lockdown, we would have in many ways contained it. Post this, it should be much, much better. But virus can pick up even if 2 people have in the country, slowly it will again grow. But now there is a significant way of identifying and isolating people who are infected. These asymptomatic people are a little bit of a problem. Nobody can test 1.4 billion people. You can't test all of them for this virus. So the best thing is we just maintain the distance even after the lockdown is over. Till we feel the wave is completely gone, till then we have to maintain this discipline. This is the way forward for all of us. Maybe, I know the daily darshan, we're taking it off, but maybe today is Sunday?
Yes, Sadhguru.
Sunday. Maybe every Sunday we will meet again.